HR employees of Reddit, what was the most ridiculous, hilarious complaint you ever received? My work has one men's toilet. Had one co-worker complain that another guy kept using the bathroom before him and doing big old poos, but the way he said it was like this guy knew when he was about to go, ninja'd in just before him, dropped a massive stinker and then forced the other guy to marinate in the smell when he went for a leak afterwards. We ended up adding a can of air freshener to the bathroom, and the next complaint that came in was the poo guy never used it. I've worked in several where they install those auto air fresheners. Beforehand it smells like crap. After the fact it smells like crap rolled in cinnamon. 20 years in HR. Two female employees visited me to complain that their female team member didn't wear underwear under her work pants. She wanted to lodge a complaint against a colleague who had a new TV delivered to the office instead of home, and she thought her colleague's spending money on the TV was irresponsible. I recently had HR tell me that one of my staff had been undersupplied in his annual leave over the past few years, and he needed to take at least 10 days off over the next 6 months to correct the leave liability, paid at a higher rate than usual to make up for the error. Of course, he could take a 2-week block or, say, a day off a week until he'd used the leave, his choice. He was so enraged over being given extra paid holidays that he wrote to our general manager to complain. Screamed at me, his boss, I know my rights, refuse the leave or even to discuss why he wouldn't take it. Anyway, I wrote his performance review this week and there are multiple goals about professional, respectful behavior that need to be reached in order for him to get a raise this year. Yeah, not so much. Oh, and he still has to take the 10 days off. HR consultant for 10 plus years. You won't believe the amount of times I've had to shut people down for trying to sell their pyramid scheme side hustle in the office. Our HR got involved when an employee attempted to sell her used sports bras on the lunchroom table. She needed the money to fuel her MLM habit. Not HR, but I have a story about an HR person that I will never forget. The company I worked for hired a new girl in the HR department. She was young and very enthusiastic. I'm sure this was probably her first job out of college. Cut to a week or so later, and I'm riding in the elevator on the way up to the executive floor, and she steps in with me. A couple floors later we stop, and an older gentleman wearing a polo shirt and jeans gets on. Before I could greet him, she says, pretty casual for a workday. How I had to stifle my laughter when he replied with, that's one of the benefits of owning the company. She turned an amazing color of red that I haven't seen since. It was all in good fun though. She ended up working there a long time. To be fair, if I was the owner, I'd have admired that. She's brave enough to pull someone up for dressing too casually for the job, which means she obviously takes her job very seriously. An employee used very derogatory terms to make fun of a customer who was in the back of the store, while talking to the customer who was at the counter, who happened to be the other customer's mother. Yikes. Was once asked to investigate a sexual harassment situation where 3 different women were coming onto a male co-worker throughout their shift. I took down the details, got the names. Easy peasy investigation, so I thought. A week later, nobody by these descriptions or names had ever worked for the company. I decided to talk to the gentleman again. After a lengthy conversation where things didn't quite stack up, I asked him how these women communicated with him. I crap you not. With a straight face, he looks me in the eye and replies telepathically like I'm some kind of idiot. I had never sent an employee for psychological evaluation up to that point and I hope never to have to again. So yeah, I was asked by a delusional schizophrenic to conduct a sex harassment investigation on the voices in his head. It's all fun and games until he blurts out "shut up UW" in the middle of a meeting. My HR department once fell for a phishing email and sent everyone's W2S to a random hacker. HR then informed everyone via a mass email, with no read receipts, at 9 PM, on a Friday, even though multiple people were on vacation and had left instructions to be called in an emergency. When I got back from my trip a week later and expressed my concern about her not actually notifying me about this, she totally brushed it off. I said, "Do you realize that I need to freeze my credit? And I'm 7 days late in doing so." She said, "No, don't freeze your credit. You won't be able to use your credit cards if you do." Another time, During a workers' comp claim, I needed to speak to our claims adjuster and she said an adjuster doesn't get assigned until after the claim is settled. That's the exact opposite of how that works. She was my stupid complaint. I was a manager and had to call our HR in on this one. We had a computer that was used by multiple people and a couple of girls complained that it had a virus and pee was always popping up when they turned it on in the morning. I decided to have a look see if someone was freaking around on the closing shift, so I looked at the security footage and lo and behold, one of the supervisors was watching pee and jerking off. When we called him in, he didn't deny it but said technically he didn't pull his dong out, he just played with it in his pants, so it's not really that bad. The HR guy just looked at him, didn't say a word until after what seemed like forever the jerker said "so I guess I'm fired" and then walked out. Smart response on the HR guy's part. My partner is in HR. Someone took a crap on the job site. He was given a photo complete with measurements. The people that complained wanted DNA testing done. He's still not sure why they measured it. So they can match the projectile with the butthole that fired it, obviously. I told my coworker as professionally as I could that it wasn't appropriate for her to be using her phone while at work, teaching kids. Supposedly, she spent all her time on Facebook. Little kids would be screaming and wailing on each other literally 10 feet away and she was totally oblivious. She complained by email to HR that I was rude and confrontational. They pulled me aside and told me to be more careful about how I spoke to coworkers. I told them my side of the story. They spoke to her again. She got a written warning. They didn't tell me what happened, but I gather from office gossip that she lost her crap and started shouting at the HR staff. Rude and confrontational perhaps? Anyway, she's on her final warning now and she has a habit of hitting on the married dads of our kids, involving children in adult matters. Why hasn't your mummy paid your fees yet? Don't you want to come to daycare? And generally being an unprofessional, self-absorbed pitter-so. Can't wait until she gets fired. You wouldn't believe the headaches that I received when management signed a new copier printer lease which reduced the overall number of printers in exchange for centrally located multiplex copiers. Evidently, people feel their social standing is signified by if they have a printer, or two, in their office. My favorite was an executive assistant who stated that, because she wears heels to work, she couldn't walk to the new copier and requested that a reasonable accommodation would be to replace the printer she had in her office. IT person here. The amount of people that have printer envy is astounding. And if they have color printing and someone else doesn't, oh man, suddenly I have a job function that requires it as well. Always seems to be the people over 45-ish that care so much. We had a complaint that the toilet roll holders were too low in the stalls because when a guy was taken a poo, his knees were hitting the holders. We then lifted all the stalls' toilet roll holders 8 inches on whole company site so no knees would hit the toilet roll holders. No complaints since. HR working for the people. My arms are short and the toilet paper holder is too far. I keep falling off my seat. HR. A woman claimed that people were spreading rumors about her sleeping with co-workers. The investigation wasn't even done yet when she moved in with one of the guys. The others showed me texts and nude pics she had sent them. And if that wasn't enough, she followed me home from the bar one night to make sure I was okay. I shut my door in her face and the next day said I was too drunk and didn't realize she was there. Had enough from everything else, I didn't even need to bring that part into the conversation with her supervisor. That's Meredith WTF. I worked in HR and my co-worker hated me. She wanted someone else to get the job I did and she would complain about me to management for anything. The final straw for everyone was when I sneezed and she slammed her keyboard on her desk. Basically ran out of the room and didn't come back for 30 minutes. Management called me in and said I was making too much noise. I told them I sneezed and they said she would complain about me every day, so they didn't believe her but had to make it look like they were doing something. She left shortly after. What a nutcase. She came in with a complaint that she tried to give one of the younger guys a hug and he refused. His story was that he basically had to run away. I had to explain to a middle-aged woman that it was not her right to hug people who didn't want to be hugged. She still didn't get it and left thinking she was still in the right. Not HR, but my company is too small to have one, so it just falls on me. Used to have an AR clerk who would snack at her desk all day long. We are a pretty casual, laid-back company, so it's not a big deal as long as she was getting her work done. But then it escalated to having food constantly being delivered. Tacos in the morning, pizza at lunch, Chinese in the afternoon. It was bizarre, and made it difficult for her to work when she's eating full meals all day. I was on the fence about saying something until she brought in an instant pot. She plugged it in and cooked a freaking pork roast at her desk. Poured in barbecue sauce she brought and ate on it all day. I was dumbfounded. It was so strange. I pulled her aside the next day and told her how unprofessional it was. She was shocked and told me I was being unfair because I never specifically said no one was allowed to bring in an instant pot. She truly seemed genuinely surprised that she wasn't allowed to do that. She scaled it down after that, but I sometimes wonder how much further she would have gone if I never said anything. At some point, there'd have to have been a full spit-roasted pig over a bed of coals. I was the complainer. My buddy was dating a girl that worked in HR at my company. Their relationship starting was totally unrelated to me. They had gone to college together. He dumped her and she didn't take it well and started threatening my job since I was still friends with him. I lodged a complaint just through the main email. Complaints@company.com or whatever it was. My complaint was assigned to guess who? I ended up having to independently schedule a meeting with the VP of HR because the regular reps and middle managers were protecting their rep rather than believing me. I was the person complained about and 2 decades later, I'm still salty about it. I got called into the HR manager's office one day and told that I was being written up for discussing inappropriate and sexual things in the office. I had never done that, ever. I was still a very much closeted gay boy at the time, so there wasn't a chance in heck I was going to talk about my sex life to the middle-aged women I worked with. Who complained about me, I asked, being young and naive. We can't tell you that. There's confidentiality rules, HR said. Okay, I understand. What was it that I supposedly said? We can't tell you that, either. You may use that to discover who lodged the complaint. So, I'm being written up because an anonymous person complained that I was saying sexual things in the office. But you won't tell me who complained or what I supposedly said. That's right. Now, please sign this form to indicate that you understand the severity of your infraction. No, I won't do that. You have to. It was a stalemate for almost 20 minutes while I refused to sign their form. They threatened to fire me, but I still refused to sign. In the end, she made some comment on the form about my unwillingness to participate in the process. Then, to top it off, the rest of the office wondered why I completely stopped speaking to all of them altogether. I refused to engage in any of the usual non-office related talk. If it was not 100% required conversation in order to do my job, I flat out ignored my co-workers' presence. Again, I was called into HR and reprimanded for my abrasive demeanor. I quit that job shortly thereafter. Not HR but a complaint raised against me. Hostile and unfriendly behavior. I had to explain to the head of HR that the complainant had walked up behind me whilst I was relieving myself at a urinal, launching into a detailed explanation of their computer problem. Rather than say shut the frick up, reboot your PC and leave me alone, I replied please log a ticket for me. So yeah, prompting them to follow the proper procedure. Never mind accosting me whilst urinating was me being hostile. The complaint was promptly filed in the under-desk circular receptacle. Then tell them. I would like to file a complaint for sexual harassment in the workplace. They were trying to look at my penis while urinating. I'm not in HR, but someone called HR on me. I work with a few people that aren't that fluent in English. One of my co-workers was trying to explain to me what kind of tacos he ate and could not remember the word for stingrays. So he took my notebook and drew a picture of a stingray and wrote the word turtle. So it looked like this. Crudely drawn stingray plus the word turtle. A lady I work with went through my notebook, saw the picture of the stingray plus the word turtle. She called HR because she thought I was writing notes about her in my notebook. She said that horribly drawn stingray plus the word turtle meant that I want to punch her in the face because she is slow like a turtle. Definitely a reach. I didn't get in trouble. I was just told by my boss that I'm not allowed to talk about turtles anymore in case it upsets her. I rarely talk about turtles, so this isn't really a problem for me. I don't know if this story fits, but I'll tell it anyway. I went to HR once to complain that my manager refused to give me a couple of vacation days. The HR lady reminded me about the boilerplate rule that vacation time must be mutually acceptable to the employee and the company. I then pulled out 6 more vacation requests that had all been denied, including one that was denied, in writing, for a reason that was not permitted. I asked her if the company is allowed to say that it's never acceptable. My last request was undenied. Not an hour employee, but I recently reported a bus driver for bringing his girlfriend to work and rubbing her feet while driving. She sat on the spot right behind the driver and put her feet where he could reach for them with one hand. I took a picture of the whole thing and debated on what to do with it for a while. On the one side, I didn't want this guy to lose his job nor have to explain why he was rubbing his girlfriend's feet at work. Imagine the awkwardness. On the other side, he missed a turn and then took a U-turn on a downhill blind curve where we could have easily gotten nailed. In the end, I came to the conclusion, when other people's lives are in your hands, that's what your hands should focus on. You did the right thing. While I can empathize with him, the safety of the passengers should be his main concern. Someone complained about another employee smelling of rotten chicken and feet. The scent was bad enough that no one wanted to work with that guy around. Had to put on a hygiene fundamentals in the workplace presentation for that entire group since I couldn't single out smelly. I think he got the hint because he also got a haircut. Somewhere out there is a guy explaining, and that is why even my hair smelled like a KFC dumpster and Tarantino's house. I was the one being complained about. A patient had asked if it was okay to remove her IV fluids cause she was going home. She was one of those people who was very convinced that if we took her fluids out, she would die. She was admitted for the common cold, and uses her insurance to pay like this so she didn't have to spend a dime. Anyway, I told her that it's okay, mom. We're just running regular saline water through your IV. No more meds. You can go home today and we can take that out. Get a notice from HR the next day saying I wasn't using proper medical terminology for IV fluids. HR didn't do crap. They just tossed the complaint at me without asking questions. I wonder what these turds would do if they actually had a real issue, if they already go to extremes for such make-believe problems. Not me, but my mom has worked in HR 20 plus years and one time had to deal with a woman who would smear her crap all over the bathroom walls on a different day each week. She must have been a real thorough hand washer because it took longer than you'd expect to find her and she was immediately fired. After 20 years in HR, I have 2 men to remember. The most recent was on Monday when an employee emailed me with a request to remind everyone to be careful with scented lotions. Her area reeked from something that smelled like Moroccan oil. These kind of emails are a bomb waiting to go off. Everyone gets paranoid, and I end up replying to 50 people that they smell fine and, yes, please keep wearing your deodorant. I told her that I would rather address it with the individual, so let me know who it was. After literally sniffing our way through the cube farm, we discovered the smell was coming from her own desk drawer. We couldn't find the stinky culprit, so she ended up throwing everything out. Case closed. It was lunchtime. A client came in. My colleague was eating a sausage roll and had it on his desk. Next day, a formal complaint came through about my colleague's sausage roll and how unprofessional it was of him to have a sausage roll he was eating on his desk. Not HR, but workers' comp. We just had an associate file a claim this week because they burned their mouth on their lunch. A lunch they brought from home and heated up in the microwave. The spineless company I used to work for would have paid the claim to not deal with it. Not HR, but I talk to people so I know a few stories. Here's my favorite in terms of how ridiculous it is. HR director found hooker in the women's bathroom. It wasn't hidden or anything. It was just there in the plain sight on the floor. Turns out one employee is addicted to smoking hooker and she brought it on her first day of work. She then demanded to be allowed to smoke hooker in the bathroom, but they came to the agreement that she can't take a break every day to go out and smoke it in the nearby hooker place if she wants to. Little background. I work in IT in Ukraine. IT specialists here make good money, and they are also spoiled as frick due to high demand. So people complain about all sorts of stupid crap all the time, like free lunches are served in containers they don't like, or elevator needs and AC and etc. I was once summoned to HR. When I got there, one of my employees was already sitting in the head HR lady's office with a WTF, really look on his face. HR lady goes into a diatribe about how this employee is a chauvinistic pig that doesn't respect women and thinks he is better than all women. On and on about just how awful this guy is. Employee was my lead software dev and was awesome at his job and a great guy otherwise. Turns out, HR lady had asked him to write a spreadsheet full of formulas to calculate open enrollment dollar values for withholding based on all the available options and individual pay rates. He told her that I can help, but I've got this payment gateway project that's due and don't really have a ton of time. Can I just show you how to get started instead? And that's how the argument started. My response was, okay employee, you can leave. Thank you. Then I told her that if Excel didn't open, that's IT. Custom sheets with formulas and pay data for employees, that's HR, and that I could recommend some resources for learning Excel. That B was constantly trying to get IT to do her job for her. Once had to tell a guy a court order means the company cannot ignore it, regardless of how much he shouted at me or threatened to kill me. I did genuinely look into it because it was the first I ever heard of anyone having money ordered by a court to be diverted. So our payroll team sent over the court order and session dates it all took place in. I asked our solicitors to look it up and see what went down, since it was all a matter of public record. Ends up our employee never bothered going to the court to contest the order and just ignored it. So armed with this knowledge, I brought him in and laid it all out. Initially he listened and just sat and waited for me to finish. Then after I'm done and explain nothing further can be done nor can we amend the payments, he explodes at me, personally blaming me for all his problems and that he can't afford these payments. Finally, after listening to him shout at me for 10 minutes and blaming me for his problems, I dropped my professional demo and flat out told him that if he bothered to defend himself in court as much as he fruitlessly was trying to do here, maybe he wouldn't be in this position. At that point he threatened to kill me, but shouted it loud enough that HR outside the meeting room heard it. My HR manager came in and just told him to leave and was fired on gross misconduct, at which point he tried to swing a punch at my HR manager, who was an amateur boxer. He knocked the guy out, put him in the recovery position and called 999 for an ambulance and police to attend our work. It was the most eventful HR meeting I ever had. We had an employee walk out in the middle of third shift, leaving one person alone to do all the work. He came back a week later and asked us to write it up like he'd been let go because he wanted to file unemployment. Obviously we wouldn't do that. Previous job, I worked with some huge butthole across the hall. I won't go into why he was in butthole, but one of the things he did was turn me into HR because I had a mini catapult on my desk, a desk toy, that shot mini marshmallows. He claimed it was a weapon and HR called me to clarify. When I told her what it was, she sighed and said if I took it home, she wouldn't make a case out of it. So I took it home. You should take a picture of the catapult, frame it, and put it on your desk. Had a lot of people ask for more hours. I would tell them I don't have more hours in your department, but I can give you hours in X department. Next schedule would come out and they would say I have too many hours, so I would give them like 10 fewer hours with still 15-25 hours, and then it would be I don't have enough hours, so then I would say okay. Remember that week when I gave you 30-35 hours and that was too much, and they would say I want 35 hours, so I would try my best and usually end up with 30 hours because hours were slim, and then it would be I have too many hours, and then I would stop talking to them because I was going crazy. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.